Welcome to part two of our Scrum training series, the Backlog Refinement Meeting. I'm Michael James. I help businesses do Scrum and related Agile practices. While Backlog Refinement falls outside the officially named meetings in Scrum, everyone's discovered a need to do it. I like to do this a couple work days before the next sprint planning meeting, giving the product owner a little time to revise priorities before commitments are made. Let's go into a team room and see this happening. The Scrum Master you're about to hear is played by a real-life Scrum Master named Nicole Lewis. Pay attention, I'm going to quiz you during the scene. At the Backlog Refinement Meeting, also called Backlog Grooming, we have a product owner, a cross-functional, self-organizing Scrum development team, and a Scrum Master. This team has just started developing a student information system to help schools track student progress.
Hello, I'll be facilitating our Backlog Refinement Meeting. Within a two-hour time box, we'll attempt to clarify and decompose the higher priority product backlog items. As you'll recall from our training, any work that represents business value or consumes time and attention from the team may be worth listing in the product backlog. One objective of this backlog refinement meeting is to create PBIs that are independent, negotiable, valuable, estimable, small, and testable. Mr. Product Owner, since you're responsible for the product vision and return on investment, why don't you start by telling us your current priorities?
Based on my vision for this product, here are my top priority items: grades, attendance, event calendar, alumni archives, and scholarship awards. Oh, and I want the pages to look really good. When can you have that done?
We have no idea. It will be done when it's done. Call us when you finish writing the requirements.
We're here to refine the requirements together. Success at Agile requires business people and developers to work together daily throughout the project. In this meeting, let's focus on the top few items only.
I'm just a tester. I don't know anything about development. I mean, do you mind if I play with my phone until you start talking about testing?
Maybe your background and skills were mostly in testing, but now you're a Scrum team member. A Scrum development team is collectively responsible for thin slices of properly tested product every sprint. Let's ask the team what they think of your involvement.
In the past, I've just written code and handed it off to another department for testing. You have years of experience with testing, and now we're in this together. I'd appreciate your expertise in this meeting.
Dude, I don't work for you.
Yes, you do, just as we work for you. On a self-organizing team, we all work for each other.
Oh, okay.
Since this meeting is time-boxed, I suggest focusing on the top item for now, grades. I propose using estimation cards to get a better cross-section of opinions about the effort to get that PBI into potentially shippable form.
This particular team likes to make estimation a game, using four cards per person, with t-shirt sizes of small, medium, large, and extra, extra, extra large.
We're estimating the effort to complete the grades PBI. Choose a card, then reveal it at the same time as everyone else. Let's hear the reasoning behind these guesses.
I picked small because displaying the grades to students is just a few lines of code.
I picked extra large because I can't imagine how we'd start testing such a vague requirement.
I picked large because I thought the requirement was to allow teachers to update grades, not just display them.
Actually, what I really want is teachers to be able to update grades, students to be able to view them online, and report cards sent to parents each semester. Now I realize I'll need your help refining the grades product backlog item.
Team seems to feel the grades PBI is actually an epic, which can be split into several distinct user stories. This is one of the purposes of this backlog refinement meeting. It turns out most people don't use most features of most products. Even the features they do use can be split into more valuable and less valuable parts. A well-formed PBI toward the top of a backlog is no bigger than a quarter of a sprint, and ideally smaller than that. Maybe we can split the grades epic into more valuable parts to get smaller user stories.
Generating the report cards will be really hard because it depends on the unreliable third-party PDF libraries.
I'm willing to put report cards on the bottom of the backlog for now if we can at least allow teachers to update grades online. They tend to lose their paper records before it's time to turn them in.
It's often useful to identify who, what, and why in a product backlog item. For example, view grades. As a student, I can see my grades online so that...
so I don't have to wait until I get to school to know whether I'm passing.
Okay, I understand that one now. It has the who, the what, and the why. It's somewhat independent, and it represents distinct business value.
If we work together, it may be small enough to get into a potentially shippable form in a couple of days.
At first glance, it seems testable.
We'll leave room to add some acceptance criteria.
What about update grades? As a teacher, I can update grades online so I no longer depend on administrators to do it for me.
Is this more or less important than view grades?
Prioritize? I want all of these features at once.
And I want a pony.
I suppose view grades has the most business value. If we didn't finish update grades, school administrators could still use the legacy system to update the grades. I wouldn't be very happy about that, though.
Feel free to reprioritize the product backlog at any time.
We're not committing to do the work in this sequence.
No commitments are made in the backlog refinement meeting. Later, when we get to the sprint planning meeting, you'll decide on how much work to take on within one sprint.
Let's try estimating the view grades PBI.
As a student, I can see my grades online, so I don't have to wait until I get to school to know whether I'm passing.
It's just a few lines of code.
I agree it's small. The UI design is simple.
Since this item doesn't alter the database, both the technical risk and the testing effort are low.
I disagree. I picked medium because the previous semester's grades are kept on a different legacy system.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Does this have to work with previous semesters or just the current semester?
I hadn't really thought about it until you asked. I'm really interested in the current semester. We won't need the previous semesters until later on.
Revote.
Looks like I'm the outlier this time. I just realized what a pain it will be to get the table display working on Ethernet Exploiter 6.
EE6? I thought we only had to support Fingerfly now.
That's correct. The district has banned the use of Ethernet Exploiter, especially EE6.
Let's make that explicit in the acceptance criteria.
In that case, I'm good with small.
Okay, I think that's enough. We've used up our two-hour time box, and I can tell from everyone's body language we're done with this meeting.
But we didn't refine the entire product backlog.
And we never will.
True. But now we have a much better picture than before of what we might do the next couple of sprints.
Don't forget agile approaches involve some planning. We just value responding to change more. I declare the backlog refinement meeting over.
The backlog refinement meeting is also called product backlog grooming, backlog estimation, and even story time. The team should set aside a little time for this every single sprint. For example, if you're doing a two-week sprint, the team should take a two-hour break somewhere in the middle for product backlog refinement. The purpose of the backlog refinement meeting is to help the product owner get the top of the product backlog ready for the next sprint planning meeting. If you haven't groomed the product backlog during sprint execution, or if it's your very first sprint, you'll need more time for this in your sprint planning meeting. The product owner cannot do this alone, the whole team has got to help. Remember, agile means business people and technical people working together constantly. Product owner must make the final call about requirements though, especially prioritization. Backlog refinement includes estimation of effort, clarification of requirements, and decomposition of large product backlog items, often called epics, into smaller ones, such as user stories. For more information on the backlog refinement meeting, please review the Scrum reference card. This concludes the training module on the backlog refinement meeting. The next one we'll talk about is the sprint planning meeting. That was just one example of a backlog refinement meeting. You can read more about this at these links, or even be guided through backlog refinement firsthand at one of our classes held around the world. To get coaching in Scrum or tools such as Scrumworks, TeamForge, or Subversion, give us a call here at CollabNet. To send feedback on this training module, email scrumwbt@collab.net or michael.james on Twitter. The next module in the series covers the sprint planning meeting.